guard me from the apple of your eye, the shadow of your wings, protect me. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with
you. And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord of mercy.
Lord of mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. So our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. You have probably heard how I have been entrusted by God with the grace he meant for you, and that it was by revelation that I was given the knowledge of the mystery, as I have just described it very shortly. If you read my words, you will have some idea of the depth that I see in the mystery of Christ. This mystery that has now been revealed through the Spirit to his holy apostles and prophets was unknown to any men in past generations. It means that pagans now share the same inheritance, that they are parts of the same body, and that the same promise has been made to them in Christ Jesus. I have been made the servant of that gospel by a gift of grace from God, who gave it to me by his own power. I, who am less than the least of all the saints, have been entrusted with this special grace, not only of proclaiming to the pagans the infinite treasure of Christ, but also of explaining how the mystery is to be dispensed. Through all the ages, this has been kept in God, the creator of everything. Why? So that the sovereignties and powers should learn only now, through the Church, how comprehensive God's wisdom really is, exactly according to the plan which he had for all eternity in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is why we are bold enough to approach God in complete confidence through our faith in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, with joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation.
With joy you shall draw water from the wells of salvation.
Truly, God is my salvation, I trust I shall not fear. For the Lord is my strength, my song, he became my saviour. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. Give thanks to the Lord, give praise to his name, make his mighty deeds known to the peoples. Declare the greatness of his name, sing a psalm to the Lord.
With joy shall draw water from the wells of salvation.
For he has done glorious deeds, made them known to all the earth. People of Zion, sing and shout for joy, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
Joy shall draw water from the wells of salvation.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The sheep that belong to me listen to my voice, says the Lord. I know them and they follow me.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, quite sure of this, that if the householder had known at what hour the burglar would come, he would not have let anyone break through the wall of his house. You too must stand ready, because the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. Peter said, Lord, do you mean this parable for us or for everyone? The Lord replied, what sort of steward then is faithful and wise enough for the master to place him over his household, to give them their allowance of food at the proper time? Happy that servant if his master's arrival finds him at this employment. I tell you truly, he will place him over everything he owns. But as for the servant who says to himself, my master is taking his time coming, and sets about beating the men servants and the maids, and eating and drinking and getting drunk, his master will come on a day he does not expect, and at an hour he does not know. The master will cut him off and send him to the same fate as the unfaithful. The servant who knows what his master wants, but has not even started to carry out those wishes, will receive very many strokes of the lash. The one who did not know but deserves to be beaten for what he has done will receive fewer strokes. When a man has had a great deal given him, a great deal will be demanded of him. When a man has had a great deal given him on trust, even more will be expected of him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are God's servants. He has placed great trust in us, and aware of this call, we turn to him in prayer. For the Church, under the guidance of Pope Francis and its fellow bishops, that has become more and more a community where people can discover their gifts and use them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who feel no need of God, may they come to see his power and beauty in every truly human achievement. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And may all Christian people, as a matter of urgency, unite to give common witness to a waiting and needy world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And we pray for all our own intentions. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all who have died. Remember Bridget Kelly on her first anniversary, and the anniversaries of Christopher O'Connor, John Hamill, Margaret Conley, Margaret Breen, Sister Olivia MacDonald, and Bridget Kelly. May their souls and the souls of all faithful departed,
to the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen. Let us pray. Lord our God, we thank you for your constant presence in our changing world. May your presence ever remind us that we are not alone. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
And may the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with
you. And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints we declare your glory, as with one voice we exclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts.
Heaven and earth are filled with
your glory.
Hosanna
in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in
the name of the Lord.
Hosanna
in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Be holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until
you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Damon, our Bishop, his assistant, Bishop Michael, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, our venerable spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. At the Saviour's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
The Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The Lamb of God.
You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Remember, most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was alone, and anyone that fled your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, my plan to you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother, to thee we are come before you in sympathy and sorrow. O Mother of the Lord, in time,
despite our petitions, bend your mercy here and answer your head.
By what you give in this present age, and prepared for the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with
and with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Go in peace and stay safe.
Thanks be to God.